locations in Chicago. Harpo Marx guest stars on I Love Lucy. Tomorrow night at 6 on Channel 32.
Come on, ladies. Now you fed it. Now you lift it. You know, just because you're married doesn't mean you can just sit there and relax. You put it there. Now you lift it up and put it down. Your husbands are going to be so proud of you. Hey, and you know what? If you work really hard at this, who knows? Maybe one of you could be Mrs. America. Shh.
Tonight from Las Vegas, the married capital of the world, the 1982 Mrs. America pageant, starring Bobby Vinton and Vikki Carr.
I'm delighted to be sharing the stage this evening with not only a beautiful lady, but a fantastic singer who is really a melody of love. I'm referring to my melody of love, Vikki Carr.
Well, I recognize that curly hair, especially that blonde, blue eyes, that smile and the charm and that voice. And there were roses and violets in my dressing room. So, it must be him. It must be him. Oh, my God. It must be him. Mr. Bobby Vinton. And now we'd like to introduce to you our 50 co-stars for the next 2 hours.
The most beautiful married women in the country, one of whom tonight will become Mrs. America 1982.
Las Vegas Hilton. It's the 1982 Mrs. America pageant, starring Bobby Vinton and Vikki Carr, and the beautiful married ladies representing each of the 50 United States. The 1982 Mrs. America pageant will continue after these messages.
The Hilton's right across the street.
Well, let's meet back at the Hilton at 8.
Meet you at the Hilton at half.
I'm over at the Hilton. Come over.
5 minutes to get to the Hilton.
I'm at the Hilton.
Let's walk over to the Hilton.
I'll meet you later at the Hilton.
You know, the Hilton's got the best steak in town.
See you at the Hilton.
And you can reach me at the Hilton. Just call me at the Hilton, and we'll get down to your business right away.
When American business hits the road, American business stops at Hilton, America's business address.
If you can't lose weight, no matter how you've tried, listen to what these people did.
With Dexatrim, I didn't get the hungries anymore, and I lost weight.
The Extra Strength Dexatrim Diet Plan, the strongest diet pill formula you can buy without prescription. One capsule curbs your appetite all day to help you eat less and lose weight.
Dexatrim kept me from overeating, and I lost weight. It works.
Extra Strength Dexatrim. No diet pill works harder to help you lose weight.
If you're going to Disneyland, Orange County, or downtown Los Angeles, we've got great news for you. Now there's a much faster way to get there and miss the mess at LAX. Jet America.
Jet America is the first major airline that flies nonstop from O'Hare to convenient Long Beach Airport on luxurious new DC-9 Super 80s. Jet America, the shortcut to L.A. Sorry, all you other airlines, we just beat you to it.
Now through August 31st, children under 12 traveling with an adult fly for half fare. Call now.
Monday at 7:30 on the movie special, Humphrey Bogart, William Holden, and Audrey Hepburn star in...
Sabrina? Who is Sabrina?
Our chauffeur's daughter. That's who she is.
Have I changed? Have I really changed?
Linus Larrabee, wizard of finance, man of distinction, chairman of the board of Larrabee Industries, getting mixed up with his chauffeur's daughter.
Sabrina, Monday at 7:30 on the movie special on Channel 32.
Vicki, tonight's a very special night for us and America's 52 million married women, since it's our chance to salute every single one of them.
That's true. And we're in a very appropriate place for giving them tribute. We're in the main showroom of the Las Vegas Hilton.
Appropriate is right. You know, we're in the gaming capital of America. And right here where we're standing, is the only room in all of Las Vegas where tonight we can guarantee a big winner.
That's right. The 1982 Mrs. America.
So let's not waste any more time in introducing our 50 contestants for that title. Here they are, each one wearing a state costume she created for tonight.
And Bobby, our first contestant is...
Mrs. Alabama, 29 years old, married 5 years, from Birmingham.
Good evening. My name is Janet Wood. My state costume represents the beautiful song, Stars Fell on Alabama.
Mrs. Alaska, 29 years old, married 7 years, from Eagle River.
Hi, I'm Wanda Badger, and I'm representing the 28,800 square miles of beautiful Alaskan glaciers.
Mrs. Arizona, 30 years old, married 10 years, from Tempe.
Good evening. My name is Debbie Adams, and my state costume represents Arizona's copper industry.
Mrs. Arkansas, 32 years old, married 10 years, comes from Magnolia.
Hi, I'm Teresa Gray, and I bring you a slice of the good life from the beautiful state of Arkansas, home of the largest watermelons in the world.
Mrs. California, 37 years old, married 4 years, and she comes from Fremont.
Buenas noches. My name is Donna Frame, and my state costume represents the Spanish heritage of California.
Mrs. Colorado, 28 years old, married 6 years, and she comes from Denver.
Hello, my name is Tony Jo Nibauer, and I'm representing the women of Colorado, the centennial state, founded July 4th, 1876.
Mrs. Connecticut, 36 years old, married 15 years, and she comes from Bridgewater.
Good evening. My name is Gretchen Rossi, and my costume represents the industries of Connecticut.
Mrs. Delaware, 35 years old. She's married 13 years, and she comes from Newark.
Good evening. I'm Carol Manita from the Diamond State, the first state to sign the Declaration of Independence.
Mrs. Florida, 28 years old, married 6 years, and she comes from Orlando.
Good evening. My name is Mona Hartnett. I'm depicting the sun goddess of Florida, bringing to you some of our warm and glorious sunshine.
Mrs. Georgia, 33 years old, married 6 years, from Smyrna.
Hello, I'm Janice Henson. My costume represents springtime in Georgia.
Mrs. Hawaii, 32 years old, married 6 years, and she comes from Honolulu.
Aloha,
My name is Lynn DiGiorgio, and I'm representing the beautiful islands of Hawaii.
Mrs. Idaho, 32 years old. She's married 9 years, and she's from Boise.
Good evening. My name is Becky Blackhall. I represent the trout industry of Idaho and its great outdoors.
Mrs. Illinois, 31 years old, married 5 years, and she comes from Rockford.
Good evening. My name is Susan Combs, and my costume represents Illinois' state flower, the violet.
Mrs. Indiana, 26 years old. She's married 7 years and comes from Anderson.
Hello, my name is Nell Gerard, and my costume represents one of our nation's greatest races, the Indianapolis 500.
Mrs. Iowa, 26 years old, married 7 years, and she comes from Oakland.
Hi, I'm Melanie Myers, and I'm representing our state flower, the wild rose.
Mrs. Kansas, 39 years old. She's married 20 years, and she comes from Salina.
Hi, I'm Carol Sperling, and I'm representing the great wheat state, Kansas.
Mrs. Kentucky, 20 years old. She's married 11 months, and she comes from Greensburg.
My name is Deanne Knuth, and I represent the land of Stephen Foster, my old Kentucky home.
Mrs. Louisiana, 35 years old, married for 17 years, and she comes from New Orleans.
Good evening. I'm Carol Ross, and I'm from the fabulous town of Dixieland Jazz.
Mrs. Maine, 26 years old. She's married 5 years, and she comes from Lewiston.
Good evening. My name is Debbie Doobie, and I represent the industries in the Pine Tree State of Maine.
Mrs. Marilyn. She's 29 years old. She's married for 5 years, and she comes from Towson.
Hello, Sharon Best, Annapolis Naval Academy.
Mrs. Massachusetts. She's 39 years old. She's married for 19 years, and she comes from Methuen.
Good evening. My name is Regina Moriarty, and I'm representing that man who fired the shot that was heard around the world, the Minuteman.
Mrs. Michigan. She's 23 years old. She's married 3 years, and she's from Grosse Pointe.
Good evening. My name is Nancy Hook, and I represent Michigan's beautiful winter wonderland.
Mrs. Minnesota, 37 years old, married 14 years, and she comes from Bloomington.
Good evening. My name is Patricia Russell, and I'm representing St. Paul's Winter Carnival Queen.
Mrs. Mississippi, 46 years old, married 26 years, from Hattiesburg.
Good evening. I'm Betty Yao, and I'm a Confederate infantry soldier. My flag is the official state flag, which is flown over the Capitol in Jackson, Mississippi.
Mrs. Missouri, 21 years old, married for 2 years, and she comes from Wablo.
Good evening. My name is Nicklin Coyle, and I represent the state bird, the bluebird.
Geography never looked like this in school. Let's take a break so I can prepare for the second 25 states of the Union of Marriage.
Well, okay, and if you haven't seen your state winner, or even if you have, our next 25 state contestants will be right here, along with lots of other surprises and prizes. So stay with us. We'll be right back.
The 1982 Mrs. America pageant will continue after these messages.
So much to do today, baby, but you keep it cool, baby. How do you do it?
Every morning I reach for Babe Antiperspirant because it has a super dry formula that really helps me keep my cool. Whatever happens today, I know I'll stay calm and dry under pressure.
So morning, noon, and night, babe, you got what it takes, babe, to keep your cool.
Good morning, and welcome to the early morning.
Keep your cool with Babe Antiperspirant by Fabergé.
If you want a tough three-ply trash bag, you're going to have to buy Glad. It's that simple, because only Glad makes the three-ply bag. Why buy Glad? Because bargain bags can do this. And that's no bargain. Glad gives you three tough plies, one layer that resists tears, reinforced by two more layers that resist punctures. Glad three-ply bags, the only three-ply trash bag you can buy. And now three-ply lawn bags, only from Glad.
This snapper riding mower has a patented cutting unit designed to create a powerful vacuum action, which means you can start early in the morning during high moisture conditions and get a smooth, even cut. With the optional 30-bushel bag and wagon, you may be able to mow your entire lawn without stopping to empty. The high vacuum snapper riding mower, the fast, easy way to keep your lawn beautiful.
For your nearest snapper dealer, dial S-N-A-P-P-E-R, snapper.
Harpo Marx guest stars on I Love Lucy. Tomorrow night at 6 on Channel 32.
Welcome back to the 1982 Mrs. America pageant. We've been bringing you the pageant winners from each of our 50 states. You know, Vikki, this pageant is really unique. Mm-hmm. In fact, it's only made possible because 50 men made hits.
And 50 misses became missus.
Right. Well, you that's easy for you to say. Huh? Seriously, this is the only nationally televised pageant that doesn't discriminate against our country's greatest natural resource, America's married women.
Resource report.
All right, Vikki, let's explain how all these 50 state winners made it here.
Sure. All our candidates must be United States citizens, a minimum of 18 years old, and unlike any other major beauty competition, our contestants must be married. And each candidate is judged in personality, intelligence, poise, outside interest, and accomplishments. And, of course, beauty.
Of course. And careful consideration is given to family life and participation and involvement in community affairs. Each state delegate is interviewed by the judges panel during pageant week, mm-hmm. and also competes in both swimsuit and evening gown competitions. And tonight, one of these state winners will be crowned Mrs. America 1982.
And as we said before, the ladies must be very imaginative. Each lady had to create her own costume, which she feels best represents her state. We've seen our first 25 state contestants. Now let's continue in alphabetical order, starting with
Mrs. Montana, 31 years old. She's married for 10 years, and she comes from Billings.
Good evening, and welcome. I'm Kristen Tolson. The Yogo Sapphire, found only in Montana, reflects the glorious blue of the Big Sky Country.
Mrs. Nebraska. She's 47 years old. She's married for 27 years and comes from Ogallala.
Howdy. I'm Bonnie Harrington from Nebraska, where we raise the nation's finest bee. And from Ogallala, cowboy capital of Nebraska.
Mrs. Nevada. She's 20 years old, married for 1 year. Comes from Caliente.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Tara Clark, and I represent the entertainment capital of the world as a showgirl from the fabulous Follies Bergère.
Mrs. New Hampshire. She's 35 years old, married for 8 years, and comes from Laconia.
Hi, my name is Linda Smith, and I'm representing my state with our beautiful state flower, the lilac.
Mrs. New Jersey. She's 34 years old, married for 15 years, and she comes from Old Tappan.
Hello, I'm Jerry Pauline from the Garden State of New Jersey, and I represent our homegrown tomatoes.
Mrs. New Mexico, 21 years old, married for 2 years, and she comes from Albuquerque.
Buenas noches, amigos. I'm Don Reisman. I'm wearing the beautiful colors of our sunsets in New Mexico.
Mrs. New York. She's 42 years old, married for 3 years, and comes from Rochester.
Hi, I'm Janet Lee Horvath. Greetings from the great state of New York, home of the Big Apple and Broadway.
Mrs. North Carolina. She's 30 years old, married for 6 years, and comes from Wake Forest.
Sir Walter Raleigh, at your service. Hello, I'm Vivian Wells. My costume depicts the dress of the founder of our state capital, Raleigh.
Mrs. North Dakota. She's 26 years old, married for 8 years, and comes from Minot.
Hello, I'm Susan Glickshore, and I'm representing the American Sioux Indians.
Mrs. Ohio. She's 41 years old, married for 23 years, and comes from Miamisburg.
Greetings, America. I'm Victoria Boyer, commemorating our own Neil Armstrong, the first man on the moon.
Mrs. Oklahoma. She's 40 years old, married for 15 years, and comes from Broken Arrow.
Good evening. I'm Diana K. Dobson. My state is 75 years old, celebrating its Diamond Jubilee. You're doing fine, Oklahoma.
Mrs. Oregon, 36 years old. She's married for 9 months, and she comes from Bend.
God bless you. I'm Carrie Edwards. My velvet and tapestry gown is representative of our pride in Ashland, Oregon, home of the Shakespearean Festival.
Mrs. Pennsylvania. She's 39 years old. She's married for 21 years and comes from Kingston.
Hello, I'm Hannah Robeson, and I represent Pennsylvania's coal industry.
Mrs. Rhode Island, 31 years old, married for 9 years, and she comes from Warwick.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Linda Parker, and my costume represents the Ocean State Mermaid.
Mrs. South Carolina. She's 37 years old, married for 6 years, and she comes from Charleston.
Hello, I'm Faye Finger. A warm southern hello from the Palmetto State and the home of the Charleston Flappers.
Mrs. South Dakota. She's 48 years old, married for 23 years, and comes from Sioux Falls.
I'm Whiffer Randall. I represent the Black Hills gold industry, from my head down to my toes.
Mrs. Tennessee, she's 29 years old. She's married for 8 months, and she comes from Nashville.
Good evening. I'm Cindy Harris. I'm representing the Flame of Energy, the official logo for the 1982 World's Fair.
Mrs. Texas. She's 29 years old. She's married for 2 months, and she comes from Houston.
Hello, everyone. I'd like to give you a great big Texas welcome from the Lone Star State.
Mrs. Utah, 32 years old, married for 8 years, and she comes from Salt Lake City.
Good evening. My name is Francine Quinn. My costume is a replica of the 1947 Centennial Queen's gown.
Mrs. Vermont, 25 years old. She's married for 2 years, and she comes from Essex Junction.
Good evening. I'm from the green state of Vermont, and I represent Samuel D. Champlain, founder of Lake Champlain in the year 1609.
Mrs. Virginia, 28 years old, married for 3 years, and she comes from Fairfax.
Hello, I'm Mary Morgan from Virginia, our first colony, in my Williamsburg ball gown.
Mrs. Washington, she's 37 years old, married for 15 years, and she comes from Bob Hill.
Hi, I'm Helen Kleffner, and I'm from the Evergreen State of Washington. I represent 24 million acres of evergreen forest.
This is West Virginia. She's 24 years old, and she's married for 2 years. And she comes from Clarksburg.
Good evening. My name is Susan Beltry, and my costume represents the beautiful craftsmanship of our state.
Mrs. Wisconsin. She's 27 years old. She's married for 4 years, and she comes from Mequon.
Good evening. My name is Linda McCormick, and my costume represents the mouse and the cheese from the dairy state, Wisconsin.
And finally, Mrs. Wyoming, 38 years old. She's married 16 years, and she comes from Cheyenne.
Good evening. My name is Regine Higginson. I represent our state gem, the Wyoming Jay.
Well, there they are, ladies and gentlemen, the most beautiful married women in America.
Bobby, all of these women deserve special recognition for their wonderful costumes. Right?
Right.
In fact, our first award of the evening is for Best State Costume. And even though costume judging does not affect the outcome of the pageant, it is an important award.
Now, who is that?
Oh, my God.
What do you have here?
I have the pleasure to announce the new first Best State Costume. I think Liberace threw up on us. Okay. But here's the first prize.
Who is
now?
She? Can I help you?
They all look sensational. Okay,
first
now here
prize,
it is.
Best costume, Francine Quinn.
Mrs. Utah!
Mrs. Utah!
What the costume represents again.
Tell us again what that is.
The original costume is in a museum in Salt Lake City, and in 1947, the Days of 47 Queen wore it to reign over the festivities during Utah's 100-year centennial celebration.
Well, it's beautiful, and that's your plate. Mrs. Utah Francine Quinn, here is your $1,000 sweater wardrobe from Hush Puppies Sweater B&B Wear. Thank you, Rip.
Oh, thank you very much. Congratulations. Rippy, we'll see you later. Goodbye.
Ladies, now it's time to change into your swimwear. Ready, set, go! Bobby, there are 50 basic reasons why all our contestants are here tonight.
That's right, Vicki, and let's give a big round of applause to all those men who made these ladies eligible for this pageant. The husbands of our contestants. Yay! Stand up, guys, think about it. The husbands.
Could read my mind.
mind right now, you'd see that I'm thinking these are a super group of men.
Yeah, if I could read your mind, you'd be reading my mind. Anyway, why don't you sing a song for the gentlemen? Something to put them in a nice romantic mood. They haven't seen their wives for a week, and they are ready for a romantic song.
You want it? You got it. Can you read my mind? Can you picture the things I'm thinking of? Wondering why you are all the wonderful things you are. You can
Vicki, believe it or not, the time is drawing closer to our first big decision of the night.
Oh, so don't go away, because we'll be right back with the announcement of our 10 semifinalists for Mrs. America 1982.
Mrs. America pageant will continue after these messages.
We were always meant to be. condition that should have been yours can be.
When you're near, my heart is free.
Make it happen. Nice and easy. It sells the most. It conditions the most.
I'll keep you near.
Hi, I changed my mind about the party tonight. I want to go.
Smells like cookies. Smells like Nestle Toll House cookies. Mmm. Somebody's baking Toll House cookies.
Enjoy great Toll House taste in the summer. Toll House pan cookies made with Nestle Toll House morsels. Just spread all the batter in one pan, and in only 20 minutes, they're ready.
Hi, Rose.
Hi, Harry.
Did you bake Toll House cookies?
Yeah, I did.
Could I borrow one?
Just one, Harry?
Nestle Toll House pan cookies, the best you can bake.
Rosie, your costs are way up. You gotta cut expenses.
Okay, let's cut your bookkeeping fee.
Get serious, Rosie. Cut out the Bounty. Buy cheaper towels and save some money.
Bite your tongue. Bounty's the best way I know to save dough.
Prove it.
Okay, wise guy, follow me. Just watch a penny's worth of Bounty against a penny's worth of an average bargain brand. Bounty absorbs all the liquid fast. The cheaper brand just can't absorb as much. But even wet, that penny's worth of Bounty's still absorbing.
You win, Rosie. Bounty really can save you money.
Like I said, Bounty's the best way I know to save dough. Now, about your fee.
My nails are wet, Walter.
But my bowling shirt's dirty.
Bowling shirt? At a banquet, Walter?
Well, we're all wearing our shirts one last time.
Okay. You wash, I'll talk you through it. Your shirt says warm.
Huh? It says Big Al's wire and pipe.
No, in here. Push warm.
Don't you need hot?
Not if you use Cheer. All temperature Cheer cleans great in cooler temperatures.
Don't I need something special?
Cheer is something special. It works in hot, but it's got a formula that cleans in warm and cold, too.
Just so we don't ruin your nails. Wow. Who knew it would get so clean?
I did. It's my Cheer. Can you zip me?
No, but I'll talk you through it.
All temperature Cheer. Tough on dirt, even in cooler water. All temperature.
Escort, made in America by Americans. Hi, I'm Harry Schmirler, your singing Ford dealer. Ford Escort is the best-selling car in the world. It has tremendous quality, and it has a super price, and Schmirler Ford most certainly has the best selection with over 500 brand-new 82 Ford Escorts in stock, on sale, and ready to go. Come on, America, buy American. The job you save may be your own. Schmirler Ford is in Racine, Kenosha, and at Route 83 and Toohey in Elk Grove Village.
America contestants, and listen to what they gave me to say. In their official gay bar swimwear by DuPont Antron Nylon and Lycra Spandex.
Well, that's easy for you to say. But speaking of things that are easy to say, how do you say photogenic in Spanish?
Oh, es muy fácil, señor. La fotogénica.
Hmm. Well, the most interesting thing is not how you say it, but how you see it. Now we're about to find out how the professionals see it.
All week, a corps of cameramen and reporters have been covering the pageant, and based on their keen eyes for beauty and years of experience in capturing it, they've voted for Mrs. Photogenic. And even though this award does not affect the eventual outcome of the Mrs. America pageant, it is an extremely important award.
And here to make the presentation is a man of many words, who the ladies have been sharing a dressing room with, because he's appearing here at the Las Vegas Hilton, Mr. Norm Crosby. Norm, come on out here.
Thank you very much, Vikki, Bobby, ladies and gentlemen. It is my extinct pleasure to present the Mrs. Photogenic Award for 1982. A young lady chosen by the press corps who represents the basic concrete abutment of filial distribution, and certainly, obviously, and evidently demonstrates flexibility and protrusion. And the word photogenic is from the Latin photo, meaning picture, and genic, which is a small town where Helen of Troy was born. Now, Helen of Troy, as I'm sure you know, had to be one of the most beautiful married women in all the world of history. Helen of Troy and her cousin Sylvia from Albany, who was her manager, enlivened married woman status to the pinnacle where it is today. She was a gorgeous woman. Helen of Troy literally could charm birds right out of the skies. People would walk down the street in ancient Rome and see birds sitting on the sidewalk. They would say, hey, Helen must have been here. You know, they knew. And who knows, but perhaps one of these beautiful ladies will pursue a career in photogenealogy. Unfortunately, last year's winner was not able to do that. You see, she was an Italian girl, and every time the photographer asked her to say cheese, she would say provolone. Just unstored her vertebrae. Well, we have a winner, and it's my pleasure to announce Mrs. Photogenic for 1982. It's a strange name.
Is?
Yes.
Is?
Hold,
is?
Hold that for
okay.
Me. It's a strange name. Mrs. Turnover Card. Oh, Turnover Card. Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of the Mrs. Photogenic Award for 1982 is Mrs. Tennessee
Cindy Harris. Cindy Harris. Mrs. Tennessee. Cindy Harris, you have won $500. $500 and a six-month Roffler Family Hair Care Center certificate. Thank you, Norm, and we thank you. Bye-bye. Norm Crosby. Well, the time has come for the judges' announcement of our 10 semifinalists. But first, let's meet the judges who made the selections.
And what a distinguished group they are. Bobby, may I start the introductions?
Yes, yes, yes.
Okay. The chairman of the board and president of Hilton Hotels Corporation and our host here in Las Vegas, the non-voting chairman of the judges panel, Mr. Baron Hilton.
Award-winning American artist who's known throughout the world for his distinguished paintings, sport, and entertainment events. He's been called the artist of the century, Mr. Leroy Neiman.
The internationally famous lawyer who founded the American Trial Lawyers Association, he's so phenomenally successful, he's earned the title King of Torts. A man who we'll see celebrated in a movie based on his life, Mr. Melvin Belli.
A woman who is the personification of the American spirit of courage, hope, and determination. She helped guide our country through the trying Iranian crisis when her husband was held hostage. Wife of former consul general in Iran, Mrs. Dorothea Moorfield.
People laugh at her wacky role as Cindy in the hit television series Three's Company, Jenny Lee Harrison.
The 1981 Woman Athlete of the Year. She finished number one in the USA in world track and field events, the world's fastest female sprinter, Evelyn Ashford.
A boating expert and marketing consultant to the marine industry, soon to attempt a powerboat endurance run from New Orleans to St. Louis to raise funds for the U.S. Olympics. He's the son of the President of the United States, Michael Reagan.
Ladies and gentlemen, our distinguished panel of judges.
like to also introduce the president and founder of the Mrs. America pageant, Mr. David Marmel.
And ladies and gentlemen, now I would like to introduce some very important men and women, our state pageant directors from around the country. For our first major decision of the evening, the announcement of our 10 semi-finalists.
Are you all holding up okay?
I can't stand the suspense. So now with the judges' decisions, from the ever-accurate accounting firm of Fox & Company, certified public accountants, Mr. Richard Gilman. Thank you. Thank you, Mr. Gilman. Okay, this is it, our 10th semi-finalist, one of whom tonight will be Mrs. America 1982. Number one, are you girls ready? Number one, Mrs. Texas. Mrs. Texas, land of the Dallas Cowboys. Number two, Mrs. Illinois. The 10 names that I am mentioning now, they are not in any particular order, so we're just going as we get them here. We're going to have now Mrs. Hawaii. South Carolina. Mrs. Nevada. Mrs. Montana. Mrs. New Jersey. Mrs. North Carolina. Mrs. Maryland. And finally, Mrs. Oregon.
Before one of these 10 women will be crowned Mrs. America 1982, so stay with them.
The 1982 Mrs. America pageant will continue after these messages.
I told two friends about Fabergé organic shampoo with pure wheat drum oil and honey, and they told two friends, and so on.
Hey, that's not Fabergé organic shampoo.
It isn't? It's an imitator. They're not all the same.
So be sure it's Fabergé.
For super body, super shine, and super fresh-smelling hair, get the one and only Fabergé organic shampoo.
You'll tell two friends, and they'll tell two friends, now you got it, and so on, and so on, and so on.
Fabergé organic shampoo and conditioner with pure wheat germ oil and...